And welcome back for some more Mass Effect 3. I'm the RPG chick. We are going to do the quest N7 communication hub, which is right here in the Kepler Verge. On the planet Ontaram. In the Newton system. Let's land. Who to bring? Garrus. Oh, no. I like bringing Edie. I just wish she interacted more in missions. Let's bring James for a change. Okay, I'm not changing guns. Let's see if we have an option to distribute points. We do. Of course, Garrus we can't use any, but James we can. Fortification I don't tend to use. So I'm going to max out his frag grenades. Increase damage to armor by 50% or damage to shields by 50%. Decisions. I don't know. What do we see more of? Do we see more armor or more shields? I am not sure here, but gotta pick one. How about shields? When I see shields, we'll throw a grenade. How about that?
Commander Cerberus has taken one of our secret communication facilities.
I know.
All campaigns in this theater depend on the information that Disarray supplies.
What do we know?
We're getting intel from a tech who survived the attack. Grace Sato. She's hiding in a security bunker off-site.
Hmm.
A civilian?
Yes, patching her through.
Miss Sato, what's happening down there?
I'm staying hidden, but I'm the only one left. They're trying to hack into our systems to access Alliance operations protocols. I'm tracking their activity, but they're bound to find me sooner or later.
Hang in there. We'll be there soon.
Yes, Commander.
It's not ideal, but she's the only one with any traction on this.
I like that flip.
The information stored in that network is critical, Commander. If it gets into enemy hands, we'll lose a lot of good people.
Got it.
I'll take care of it, Admiral.
We'll kick their ass.
See that you do. Hack it out.
See that you do. That's an awful lot of satellite dishes. Critical access points, huh? So I am using this, good.
Control of the three critical access.
Nice. Oh, I didn't see that guy who's actually closer. Shields here, okay. Throw the frag grenade.
I'm updating your last point with the
location of the terminal? Cool.
We'll keep them from hacking in.
Yeah. What the hell are you yelling about?
Oh,
can't afford this? We should have brought more money. You know to go not to go shopping without money. Boom. I hear that. Something screaming. Still got enemies? Oh yeah, they're up there. But now they're down there. Can hit him with that overload or what? I can't run all the way up there. It's almost dead though. Sounds painful. Actiony music. Alright, so I'm gonna look around all down here before I start hitting up ladders and stuff. And ramps. Goodies and stuff like that. Well, we got plastic, like, barrels and stuff. Ammo. Oh, med kit. I don't get experience anymore, let me just see. Nope. Because I am max level. I'm just gonna leave them. Just in case, I don't know. There's no reason for me to pick them up if I have full ammo. Cerberus technology. 3,000 credits. I doubt I need this money anymore either. I could probably buy a couple like high grade guns. Maybe I'll remember to do that when I get back to the Normandy and or Citadel. Okay, so we've got a ladder down. This is where we were. What's this? Oh, more technology. Ooh, Ariake Technologies Greaves. Who knew they'd call things Greaves? I mean, you don't really see Greaves in anything other than, like, you know, fantasy RPGs, medieval stuff. There's an awful lot of medkits thrown around. And not a lot of enemies to warrant their use, unless this, we're going to come across more at some point. This is a rather big area. So Cerberus hacking devices. Oh, this. I guess we should hit this thing. And now more of them come?
Cerberus shuttles are scouring the area. I think they're looking for me.
We're using comms to pinpoint Sato's location.
Oh no. How do we...
Nothing's changed. Just upload the...
Yep, there's more. They're not sold in any store.
Next set of coordinates.
Yes, Commander. Updating your nav point.
I'm just loving that lately. First aid for squad. Okay, so this combo will work nicely. Oh. You're behind me, so that's not an effective use of my cover, is it? Oh my. Where? Aha, I see you. Well, that was fun. There's probably more. I hear something. I see something. Oh. Can we pick up two at a time? You got a sniper somewhere. Aha! A nemesis. With shields, I can go like this. And it's dead. I was gonna try saving. Ah, they're in there. Okay, I was like almost dead. There's another device there. Was that always there? Alright. We'll hack it. Like hack it. 1,000 credits. I'm glad you're friendly.
Miss Sato, come in. Miss Sato, are you there?
Must be afraid to break radio silence.
We need the final coordinates. Grace, listen to me.
We haven't explored this whole area,
though. Talk. They're right outside.
Get a grip. We need you, I guess. Better than saying get a grip.
I know you're scared. This is more than you signed up for, but I won't let you down. I promise.
Okay, Commander. Updating your nav point with the last location now. But if you get to me in time... Just hurry, please.
Commander, I think I can make a run and get her.
Do it.
So it's... where? Inside the building, right? Which, we haven't gone there yet. I was like, Cortez is gonna get her, so we don't have to hurry and stuff, right? I guess I'm not covered well there. Not sure where all the enemy is right now. Kinda clueless right now. It sounds like they're all around me. I guess they're up there. Oh, I... Pew, pew, pew! Oh, we got phantom thing. I guess I'll try this. What are you shooting at? Oh, they're up in there. I see them. Yeah, it's not working very well. I'm gonna have to run up there and go get them. Gotta go that way anyway. I'd rather go up the ramp. So I'm in control the whole time. Doesn't even see me. You guys, stop yelling. I don't want to charge because that guy's... Oh. Where's the other? What? Right there! Or... Hello there! Ugh. So there's the hacking device. I just want to look around in here. We have not actually been up here. Have I been over here? I guess so. There's more? Ah! Hmm. What's out here? Oh, there's... Keep running. Oh, hello there! More people shooting at me. Out of all the, like, the levels in this one, I find that it's the hardest for me to tell where they're coming from. I'm sure that's designed to give you a challenge, that kind of thing. Which is fine by me, I'm just making an observation. Observe this! Alright, let's do this. You got it?
Cleared. Picking up Miss Sato, then heading back to the rendezvous point.
Good job, Lieutenant.
Oh, I thought we had to head back. Okay, cool.
Our communication station is secure.
Quick mission.
Operations in this theater are safe again. No small task to keep it that way. How's Miss Sato doing?
She has to be transferred to a nearby Alliance station. She wants to help however she can.
Good. We need all the help we can get.
We sure do. Well, I don't want to make a 19-minute episode, so... What are we doing now? The last few systems we explored, we got a few assets, so I haven't looked over those yet. Alien. Shadow Broker Support Team. The Shadow Broker's strength lies in her connections. Dr. Liara Tassoni has a team of operatives able to procure almost any supplies at any time by using an extensive network of bribes, blackmail, and favors. This logistical support has become important to building the Crucible, as the disruption of communications and travel makes gathering resources risky at the best of times. That's it. Alliance. Right, we've got an update for both of these division fleet. That one's completely new. 103rd Marine Division update. I'm not sure which one's new. I don't remember. I don't remember stuff. Nicknamed the Bridge Burners, Team Zeta are combat engineers who specialize in destroying enemy fortifications in hostile territory. This tight-knit group of men and women are respected for their knowledge, renowned for their tenacity, and infamous for their enthusiasm. See, I don't remember that one. The Alliance Marine Reconnaissance Unit flies recon drones and occasionally puts live recon teams into play. AMRU works hard to ensure information is up to date, using VIs to disseminate intel as quickly as possible. This I know. Grissom Academy. Commander Shepard's interview with Diana Allers about the attempted takeover of the Citadel noted Cerberus's tactical missteps, which improved the morale of Alliance ground forces. Yeah, I think that was our earlier interview with her. Okay, Alliance Third Fleet updates. The SSV Nairobi is a top-of-the-line cruiser with the showroom finish of a ship just off the factory line. As it has never seen warfare, the Nairobi's officers have been running mock battles in preparation for real enemy contact. And the Trafalgar was in the middle of an engine overhaul when a Cerberus flotilla engaged it in a firefight. Barely escaping on auxiliary power, its crew later finished upgrading the ship in record time after meeting Alliance forces. And then we got communications arrays. Before fleeing Antaram with Commander Shepard's help, technician Grace Sato saved a copy of the schematics for the Alliance's most advanced communications relay. Sato will use these schematics to build several smaller relays to collect crucial intel from points in various systems. Cool. Crucible. Right, this is the other Shadow Broker thing. Shadow Broker Starship Tech. The Shadow Broker's unnamed vessel served as both... Right, so we found this on... I wrote it down. We found it on Hagalaz. Hagalaz... Where is that? In the Sowillo System Hourglass Nebula. The Shadow Broker's unnamed vessel served as both a data repository and stealth ship for the enigmatic information trader. The ship ingeniously drew its power from the thunderstorms raging constantly on the planet it orbited, relying on an interlocking system of kinetic barriers, grounding rods, and capacitors to avoid being ripped apart. Yeah, that was an exciting mission, just getting in that place. These systems have been repurposed for sections of the Citadel that require the safe discharge of tremendous amounts of energy. Terminus Freighters. The Terminus systems teem with planets rich in rare elements, minerals, and other raw materials important for the Crucible. Fortunately, the Terminus systems also have a great quantity of freighter vessels. Athabasca-class ships, while only lightly armored, can carry millions of tons of freight with fuel tanks optimized for long, hazardous journeys. That's it for that one. And these are all of our assets. Now, still going to be a short episode, as it is now, so let's run around and see if anyone else has anything to say, which is probably not, since this was just a tiny mission. And none of these people have anything to say.
Commander?
Nothing here. Nothing here.
Joker, you asked for news about the human colony, Tiptree.
Hey, Liara, you don't need to worry about that right now.
Now's as good a time as any. I'm getting reports of refugee ships from Tiptree landing on Solarian colonies. I don't have names. I'm sorry. It was mostly children.
Well, Gunny, Hillary, my sister, Gunny's the nickname she's had it since, she's only 15, so if it's children, then maybe I only lost my dad. Kind of an asshole thing to hope for.
Jeff, right now, take any kind of hope you can get.
Thanks. You too.
Okay. I was beginning to think we wouldn't have any updates here.
Commander?
How's the ship holding up, Edie?
The envelope of mass-free space we create when we travel at FTL limits any impact of micro-collisions with ambient dust. Nevertheless, Some ablation does occur at subluminal speeds. Normandy will need maintenance before the year is out.
If we live that long, I will totally spring for it.
Hello, Shepard.
Okay, so there's that little bit, but they don't have anything new to say. So I'm going to look through the rest of the ship. If no one has anything new to say, I'm going to cut it out.
Just got word from Miss Sato. She arrived at the Alliance Research Facility safe and sound.
Yeah, and Esteban got to play hero with the damsel in distress.
You know me and my damsels, Mr. Vega.
That I do.
Hello, Commander.
Well, at least he had something to say. Oh, we need to check out those Greaves. So I guess we are going to have some content here.
Ready when you are. Ready when you are.
Right, let's look at these Greaves. I don't remember the company, but Greaves are arms, I believe. Or legs. Well, I'm just looking through all of them so you guys can look at them. Greaves might even be shoulders. Definitely not chest. Yeah, I don't even know. Sorry, guys. I know I could look it up, what Greaves are, but I'm not gonna be messing around on my phone. Sometimes I know what they are, then I forget. So if you guys tell me, I will learn and then probably forget a minute later. It's one of those things. Words that we don't use often in current society. Oh! Our engineer, where is he?
Nothing to report.
Shepard?
Now it's like they finish each other's sentences.
Commander.
Commander.
So Adams and Engineer Adams, Dr. Chakwas in the mess hall. Okay. I always forget which one she's in. Ashley. And she's not there, she's behind us.
Good to see you. Good to see you.
Good to see ya. Good to see ya. Alright, let's see what these guys are doing.
We're all machines. Carbon or silicon? Is there really a difference?
People feel emotion. Artificial intelligence is programmed.
Punch me, I get angry. I don't choose. I just get angry. Our emotions are programming.
That's not the same thing. Our emotions are a natural response.
Disease? Parasites? Lions ate their prey alive. Nature can be horrible.
So now you're siding with the Reapers?
Just because I'm saying the Reapers are alive doesn't mean I want them to stay that way. But we need to break free of nature and open our minds to new forms of life.
So you believe the Geth share the same rights and liberties as any organic being?
If that Geth is minding his own business, he has more rights than Cerberus.
Despite my disgust for Cerberus, they're still human.
Huh.
The Geth are just machines.
We're all machines, carbon or silicon. Is there really a difference?
People feel emotion. Artificial intelligence is programmed.
Punch me, I get angry. I don't choose.
And we see how they can go in circles with us. Literally. I'm gonna have to back engineer Adams on this one.
Genetics don't make us alive. It's our self-awareness, curiosity, capacity to evolve.
Well put, Commander.
Of course you'd say that. You two are practically machines yourselves.
What? That's a funny thing for a doctor to say.
Good to see you, Commander.
So I'm a machine, am I?
How are you, Commander?
My nuts and bolts are working just fine, thank you. Let's go check on Garrus. That's right, we have a question thing to check in Liara's cabin.
How's it going?
How's it going? Let's go do that now. Well, that was interesting.
Excellent find, Commander. The information network terminal has been updated.
Okay. Research data from Pragya. Data on experimental gene therapies was buried in the ruins of the Pragya Research Facility. While most gene therapy takes years to show results, Pragya scientists discovered a way to shorten the process. Right, this is where, Jack was, held, for lack of a better word at this point. Two intact sample vials have been recovered from the facility. The only limiting factor is that no more than one such therapy can be applied per 10-month period without causing severe nerve damage to the recipient. Okay. Power recharge speed plus 5%. Use gene therapy to increase your skill speed or power damage. Use gene therapy to improve your damage. Let's do that. Just make sure we don't use more than one. We'll cause genetic damage to ourselves.
Perhaps we can talk later.
And nothing new here. Cool. And I believe next episode we're heading back to the Citadel. Again, we have some stuff to do. If nothing comes of it, I'll cut it out, but there's two people who... Is it in here? Yeah, Samantha Trainer. I'm not sure. It might be down there further. I think it might be holdovers from... But I swear some people... There's a couple people who want to play those matches, the virtual matches, Armax Arms. So if that's going on next episode... I mean, if that's available, if we can play against them, we'll do it. Otherwise, we're continuing with the main quest, I suppose, which is, yeah. I haven't found this thing yet. So Priority Horizon, which is a sanctuary. Sanctuary! So thanks for watching, guys. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.